Okay, so today we have Lullaby by Low. This band has been requested a few times, and I didn't know what song to go with, and I ended up going with Lullaby, which is a 9 minute and 49 second tune. So I said, why not, do it all? So yeah, anyway, I guess that's all I'm gonna say at the top, so let's get into it, and I will talk to you guys in 10 minutes. Here we go. In for a ride. Heavy.
Cross over and turn.
Love the echoing, the reverb, whatever.
We are. Was not supposed to make you cry. I sang the words I meant.
Oh my gosh. Such a simple melody, but holy shit.
Thank you.
Okay, so there it is, Lullaby by Low. So 10 minutes pretty much, holy moly. And what I like I said at the top, it was felt like it was gonna be a ride, and it was a ride. Okay, I mean, where do I start? I mean, my goodness gracious, there's so much that just happened. But so I wanna say, you know, I know that in this, you know, the band here was basically compromised or formed by a husband and wife. It was Alan Sparhawk, I want to say. Yes, Alan Sparhawk and Mimi Parker. And obviously, I want to say that Mimi passed away last year, 2022, November, from ovarian cancer. So, I mean, that sucks to hear that, you know, I didn't. She's gone now, and I never heard of her band before this. But anyway, her vocals here, obviously, you know, I see, you know, the word soprano thrown around for her vocals, and obviously, just a high and powerful voice she had. Felt like, you know, she could shatter glass or something. It's just like Jesus. I mean, she kind of scared me when she came in. I think it was around the 52nd, no, 30 something second mark, whatever. I wasn't expecting a voice so kind of that early, I guess. But yeah, she comes in, and it's just like, you know, her voice was just so captivating. The song was breathtaking. I mean, all these things. It's just like, holy moly. And like I said, during the song as well, it's a simple melody, but they just stretched it out to like 10 minutes, and it didn't feel like it was 10 minutes long. I mean, she stopped singing at around 3 minutes, I think it was. So like the last 7 minutes was just an instrumental, and it was just glorious. And how, you know, they built from the start, you know, it was just so simple. Those guitar chords and the bass was just heavy. The whole song's heavy, but the bass was, you know, so prominent from John Nichols here. And it's just so heavy there. And then, you know, she comes in, it's just like that. And honestly, the feeling I got here was Joy Division. A song that might come to mind is like Neon Fades. But many Joy Division songs. It just reminded me, John really reminded me of Peter Hook, Hookie from Joy Division. And honestly, even friggin' Alan, his guitar kind of reminded me of Bernard Sumner. And friggin' Mimi's voice reminded me of Ian Curtis. No, I'm just joking. But anyway, that was dumb. But anyway, yeah, I loved Mimi's voice. She was just so good, like I said, so strong. And it's just like I wanted to hear her more almost. It's just like this makes me want to listen to more Low. And the name of the freaking song here, Lullaby, really fits. I mean, it's so, like I said, it built slowly, built up, you know, freaking melodically and everything. And I guess it was around like the 6 minute mark, I think it was, where you know, it really was at like its peak, and then it comes back down, and you know, around the 9 minute mark, it was like back to where they were at the start. So I just love the whole, you know, the whole arrangement, I guess, and how they ended up back where they started. You know, it was such a trip. It was such a beautiful freaking song. I don't know what else to say. It's just like, you know, it's just my God. And I see so many people in the comments here talking about how the song makes them emotional. I mean, this song just evokes emotion. Obviously, freaking Mimi's voice evokes emotion as well. And it's just like, you know, how can a, you know, a guitar, a bass. And it says percussion here. It doesn't say drums. It just says percussion. But yeah, you know, instruments are sparse here. But it's almost crazy that this is just three people. But I guess it makes sense. But yeah, it's just like I don't know. It's just beautiful. It's incredible what they did here. I feel like I was lost, you know, in space at some points here as well. Just kind of staring off, you know, listening to the music. I don't know. I guess that's what, you know, that's the point. You get lost in the music and you just listen. But anyway, if you could tell, you know, during the reaction there. But yeah, I really enjoyed this to bits. So anyway, the lyrics here, just two verses. I mean, my goodness, and then an instrumental. So cross over and turn. So when she said that, I was like, well, crossover, I'm thinking, you know, death, right off the bat, you know, death crossing over, my goodness. Feel the spot, don't let it burn. We all want, we all yearn, be soft, don't be stern. So just for the first verse, I'm thinking, you know, the whole thing, you know, be soft, don't be stern, it's just like, you know, be nice, be happy kind of a thing, you know. Don't be stern, don't be mean, or whatever. We all want, we all yearn. You go into the second verse, Lullaby, and my God, her delivery, you know, I talk about how they, you know, stretch out the song, the way she could stretch out her words, just beautiful too, and so powerful. And then one more thing, maybe it's just because I like ASMR or whatever, I don't know, but maybe it's just the headphones as well. But I loved how you could hear her lips kind of smacking, you know, before she would sing. It's like you could hear her lips. It's just it sounds kind of weird to say, but you could hear her, and it's just like, oh, she's coming in now. And yeah, anyway, when she would go on to Lullaby, and then was not supposed to make you cry. I sang the words I meant I sang. It feels dark here. It feels dark. It's just like, you know, the song, I mean, I guess, you know, it seems like it would be kind of dark. And the lyrics here, I don't know, I'm feeling some darkness as well. And again, lullaby, lullaby, and I'm talking about death here. Is it like a baby or something, you know, die? I don't know. That's what comes to my head. And I think it's kind of funny, not maybe funny, ironic, is that the word? I don't know. But how she says, it wasn't supposed to make you cry. But then there's people in the comments who talk about how the song makes them cry. So it's almost like I feel like Mimi is talking to the listener. Because, you know, so many people I see are saying they have tears coming down their eyes listening to this. So anyway, I just thought that was kind of funny there. I sang the words I meant I sang. You know, talking about, again, you know, I meant these words. I sang them. Wasn't supposed to make you cry. Lullaby. It's just like, holy moly. But anyway, there is one annotation here for the first verse, and it just talks, basically, I feel like it just covers the whole song, and there's quite a few upvotes on it, so I might as well just read it, what the heck. So, again, crossing over and turning and all this stuff. So it says, the idea of crossing over could allude to a couple things. It could just be crossing over into sleep, letting the mind drift to a place where it runs and dreams, a fantasy of one's own making. And again, you're talking about here, you know, dreams and stuff. You know, I think this would be considered dream pop. Also, I do know that this is considered slowcore, but apparently the band didn't like that label. So slowcore, whatever, I apologize to the band. It also goes on, or it could mean crossing over into death. So like I said, the idea of having to cross over, you know, into a spiritual and mental boundary going on. It goes on and on. Yeah, this person may be crossing over to death and turning back to look at their own life in regret. I mean, this song does sound a little bit regretful. I mean, there's sorrow there, obviously, as well. So I guess, you know, that's what, I don't have a concrete answer for what, you know, the song is all about. And I mean, obviously, again, just these kind of two short verses, but it's a very thought-provoking song. I mean, my God, and obviously with like the 7-minute instrumental, it's just like, for how, you know, like I said, how that builds up and then comes back down, you know, that's just all emotional and thought-provoking on its own as well, you know, just with the fucking instruments. It's just like, my God, what they did here is just so beautiful and so pretty and incredible. I mean, all these adjectives, whatever you want to use, it works. And I guess that's all I gotta say there. I talked about Joy Division. Is there anything else I really need to say? I mean, my goodness gracious, hold the phone. I guess I could just end it, you know, by saying it's a song that really pulls you in. Maybe you don't feel it off the top, but I, you know, the gentle guitar playing there, you're just wondering what's going to come. And then obviously, you know, it's just, it's a beautiful ride that comes along. Obviously, rest in peace to Mimi Parker here. And again, I just love it. It's so sweet that it was a husband and wife kind of thing here. And that this was, I think, their first album. The song was from the first album, and you know, in 1994 it was released. And also one more thing, I guess, for 94, you know, and recording this probably in 93 or whatever, for the time, you know, grunge was huge. I mean, you had many alt rock and indie bands, you know, with blistering sounds, and then you come here and you have Low with Lullaby, and it's just like such a stark contrast to many other songs that were big at the time. And it's just like, this is just so dreamy, and you just get lost in it. And I mean, like I said, they did get up to a crescendo here as well, but you know, it's just so different, and for the time especially. And my God. I'll definitely have to come back to some more Low. I really enjoyed this. This was very nice. So anyway, and again, I feel like I should have been in the dark or something, you know. It would have been nicer, could have vibed to it even more. But anyway, I guess that's all I gotta say. I mean, obviously this video is already long enough because the song is like 10 minutes, but my God, it wouldn't change a thing. Holy moly. Anyway, thanks for watching. Thanks for liking, subscribing, commenting, all that stuff. And thanks for requesting Low, my goodness gracious. And before I burp, I will talk to you guys again soon.